The discussion today, in the next few minutes, that we would engage in a dialogue would be about the ills of Dobigen and how to overcome that. And many a time in today's contemporary world, if you ask people what is go between, most people would not be able to answer it correctly. Sri Siddh Thakur has defined it, as you see, as we move on, you can see the definition of go between Sri Siddh Thakur has given. As we look at this definition given by Sri Siddh Thakur, he says in such a profound and powerful way, go-between is the act which goes between a promised and intended act, and thus it interferes with the successful completion of what we had in mind. So sometimes, or many a time in our day-to-day personal, professional life, we make promises, we make commitment. And many a time we fulfill our commitments, sometimes we don't. Many people habitually, as a matter of fact, as a matter of principle, come what may, fulfill their promise every time they make one. And there are many who habitually break their promises, no matter how difficult or easy the act, the task was. So go between, which in Hindi is called Dvandi Priti, is an act which goes between our promised and intended act. It goes between the two, which interferes with the successful completion of what we had in mind. So essentially, when we break our promise, we deceive our mind. Because that's where we have not just made a commitment, a promise to somebody else, we have also made a promise to ourselves. So whatever we had in our mind, we cheat or deceive our mind. And as we continue doing that, this could become a very dangerous, detrimental aspect of our character. In the next message that I'm sharing with you, as you can see here, it is a small part of a large message Sri Siddh Thakur has shared in the message volume 5. And this extract, what I'm sharing with you, goes like this. Sri Siddh Thakur says, never give any positive word to anyone about anything which is not in your ownership and in your positive custody, because you may fail to supply that. Be not the cause of undue suffering to anyone in any way. See how meaningful this statement is. Sometimes we make promises without even thinking about it, without even thinking about the consequences. If I tell somebody that I will meet you at 3 p.m., that person must be waiting for me to meet at 3 p.m. If I say somebody that I will repay your loan in the next 15 days, that person must be waiting for me to repay, and then he might need that money in the next 15 days. If I don't do that, it could be the cause of suffering for that person. And many a time we don't realize that. Sri Siddh Thakur says, if something is not within your ownership, which is not within your control, do not make that promise. Do not be the cause of suffering to another person. As we look at the next message of Sri Siddh Thakur, once again, Sri Siddh Thakur, in a very clearing voice, tells us, if you have given anyone your word in any affair, do not fail in the least to do according to your word. Yet, if you cannot accomplish it, let him know as soon as possible and delight him with humility and modesty, and be vigilant if there is any way, help him sincerely as far as possible in that way. So if you have to give what to anyone, take well into account whether it is something within your normal capacity, then give your word. So Sri Thakur has said this about making your promises and fulfilling them. He says, once you make a promise, fulfill it come what may. There is absolutely no compromise. But sometimes in our lives, we make a promise and some unplanned unexpected event takes place. And then we know that we'll not be able to fulfill our promise. Sister Thakur says, when you get to know about it, when you get a hint about it, when you feel or think that you will not be able to fulfill the promise that you have made, go back to that person. Tell him that I am facing this difficulty. Tell him with humility and modesty, and try your best to help him in whichever way you can. If you cannot fulfill that promise, if you cannot help that person, if you can have somebody else help that person, do that. Try everything possible to make that happen. Sister Thakur is saying that if you believe that you are not very confident about fulfilling your promise, don't say that I will do it within a certain time frame. If you can, you can probably say, let me see if I can do it. Let me try to do it. But Thakur has again cautioned us. Trying to do it does not mean washing your hands by saying, friend, I only said I will try to do it. I did not promise it. Thakur again is very clear. He said, the moment you say I will try to do it, you must sincerely try, do everything that you can, do everything that is possible to make sure that you can fulfill your promise. So trying is not about escaping or getting away by just saying yes to somebody. When you say try, you must fulfill it. But if you believe you can't even try, don't even say that. So go between essentially is not just about giving a promise and breaking it. It's also about having something in mind and not carrying it out. For example, if you have decided, many of us are satsangis, we reach out to other people, and then when there is, when we are carrying out Lord's work, we go and beg for some oblation, we go and beg for some offering from other Guru Bhais and others. But if you are collecting any argya for any particular event of Thakur, if you are collecting offerings from others for the celebration of Sri Sri Thakur's birth anniversary, you cannot spend that money for the celebration of Sri Sri Borma's birth anniversary. That is also go between. As you can see in the next message of Sister Thakur, he says, spend money for the purpose it has been meant for, because it has been charged with your volition urge accordingly. So go between, we need to understand the essence of go between, and we need to see how we can carry out this absolutely clarion call from Sri Sri Thakur about go between. Sri Sri Thakur has said that somebody may be highly qualified, extremely competent, very, very efficient, but if he has this one small flaw in his character, if he indulges in go between, his all his knowledge, his qualification, his experience, his background, everything is meaningless and useless if he just has one small flaw in his character, which is go between. Now let's look at a couple of incidents from Sri Sri Thakur's life. Sri Sri Thakur, who's a love lord, who has taught us through his actions. And when Sri Sri Thakur was a small child, on one occasion, Sri Sri Thakur's grandmother asked him one day to go to the market to buy some betel leaves and some lime. The lime that we sprayed on the betel leaves, Pan and Chun. Sister Thak, his grandmother called him near her, and then she was holding 2 1-paise coins in her hands. She put one coin in the left hand of Sister Thakur and then said, you will buy betel with this. And she put the other coin on the right hand of Sister Thakur and then said, you will buy Chun, lime, with this coin. One coin to buy Pan, another coin to buy Chun. So the little boy that Sri Sri Thakur was, he started, walking towards the market. It was a bit of a long distance. In the course of the walking, somehow by mistake, these two coins got mixed up. Both the coins got mixed up. And by the time Sister Thakur, the young boy Anukul, reached the market, he realized these two coins have now been mixed up. He was not sure which coin was to buy pan, which coin was to buy chun. And he was confused. He did not know what to do. He came back home, he came walking back to his home again and met his grandmother and said, "Grandma, I am extremely sorry. I made a mistake. I mixed up both the coins, both the 1 paise coins, and I did not know which one you gave me for pan, which one you gave me for chun." His grandmother was surprised. She said, "How does it matter? You could have bought, you could have used one coin to buy betel leaves. You could have used the other coin to buy lime. How does it matter?" But the boy Anukul was confused. He was not able to understand. How can he do that? His grandmother gave one particular coin to buy betel leaves, another to buy lime. How can he mix it up? This is our Sri Sri Thakur. He teaches us through his own actions. On another occasion, Mr. Thakur was in school. He was about 8 or 9 years old. Once he was traveling with his friend by train from the Naihati railway station to Shialdah railway station. And he lost his friend on the way. And the train finally reached the Shialdah railway station. And he was traveling from Shialdah to Naihati. And the train reached the Naihati railway station. The boy, young boy Anukul, got down from the train. And he went straight to the station master's office. And he said, "Sir, I have sent a message to my Jamai Babu. He is going to come back soon. I have not bought the ticket. And he is going to come here, pay the value of the ticket, pay the price of the ticket, and he will take me from here." The station master was surprised. He said, "But I didn't ask you for money. I didn't stop you. How come you came straight to my office and then said that your Jamai Babu is coming to pay the price of the ticket?" The boy Anukul said, "Sir, I travel from Shialdah to Naihati. How can I do that without paying the price of the ticket? I must pay before I leave the station." This is Sri Sri Thakur. Sri Sri Thakur has said, "My life is my message. My life is my message. My message is my life. I have not said something in my entire life which I have not practiced myself, which I have not done myself. I have never said anything which is impractical. I have never said anything which I have not tried and tested myself." On another occasion, Thakur called one of the devotees and he said, "Hey, can you get me 300 rupees? The man got up and then said, "Thakur, I already have 300 rupees which was collected for some other purpose. Can I bring it to you, Thakur?" Thakur said, "Hey, what are you saying? Are you going to take off the crown from Narayan's head? Are you going to use something, some money which was collected for some other purpose? You cannot do that. This is go between." So I wanted to share this few incidents from Sri Sri Thakur's life to understand how Sri Sri Thakur himself practiced fulfilling his commitment, how he practiced that whatever he said, he always materialized that. As we look at the next message of Sri Sri Thakur, Sri Sri Thakur talks about the harmful effects of go-between. And in this one small message, very powerfully and very candidly, emphatically, Sri Sri Thakur says, "Beware of go-between, otherwise the knocking shock of mishandling may tear you with every fettered fate." Sri Sri Thakur says, "Go-between, consistent practice of go-between can bring you disaster. It can destroy you. It can spoil your life. It can take your push your life into a tailspin. We do not realize the seriousness of go-between. We do not realize how damaging, how harmful go-between can be if we indulge in go-between. We continuously, many of us, absolutely ignore and neglect, and we believe it's all right, it's okay if I cannot fulfill my promise. But Shri Thakur says, if you are a devotee and if you're sincerely practicing yajan, yajan and ishtavritti, and if you are a very competent guru bhai, that's satsangi, but if you have this small flaw in your character, all the benefits of yajan, yajan, ishtavritti that you would have got in a manifold way will be diminished significantly, considerably. What you would have gone in abundance, you will get in a very small quantity. So this is how damaging go-between can be. As we look in the next slide, what happens to people who indulge in go-between generally? Such people are generally ungrateful, undependable, irresponsible. They're habitually forgetful. They're idle. They're fussy about things. They're lazy. They generally do not value time, their own time and others' time. They're eager to borrow but unwilling to pay back. They blame others for their own failure to keep their promises. If they can't keep the promise, they find somebody else to be at fault for that. They don't think that they're responsible. And they're the ones whose thoughts, habits, activities, income, expenditure, planning, everything is in complete disorder. Everything is absolutely out of order, out of sync, out of harmony. Do we want to become such people? And if you indulge in go-between, generally this is how people will look at us. Imagine for a moment, somebody who is a very, very dependable person. Think about a person, a friend, a colleague, a family member, a man in the society. Think about somebody who is very, very dependable, reliable, responsible. One important characteristic of that person, generally, I can say with confidence and absolute surety that that person must be keeping his promise all the time. He must be trying very, very sincerely and genuinely to keep his promise all the time. Think about a profession where people who practice that profession are generally undependable. I don't have to name the profession. Many of us know that. People in that profession make lots of promises and they break those promises. And generally, they're not dependable. We can't trust them. They're not trustworthy. We can't believe one word what they say. We need to keep this in mind that we cannot move around in this society with the tag of being ungrateful, undependable, irresponsible, habitually forgetful, idle, fussy, and so on. Sister Thakur says, negligence is a cousin sister of misfortune. So if you neglect our words, if you neglect a promise, if you neglect a commitment, this is only going to bring us misfortune. Sister Thakur has described go-between as a disease. Sister Thakur has scientifically analyzed this and he said, as you break your promises day after day, week after week, month after month, the wearing of your brain will be tuned to breaking promises. Making a promise to a friend is also making a promise to yourself. And as you make a promise to yourself and you break it, you create a tension in your brain. You create a stress in your brain. You create a sense of inferiority complex in your brain. And slowly, you start believing about your incapacity. You start believing that whatever you promise, you can't fulfill. your brain naturally, spontaneously accepts the fact that if a promise is made, is meant to be broken. And that becomes natural and spontaneous in you. Then you get into the vicious cycle of making promises and breaking promises, and getting out of that, Sri Thakur says, becomes extremely difficult thereafter. It becomes extremely difficult. The moment you get into that vicious circle, this spiral, that habit of making and breaking promises, it will become extremely difficult for you to come out of it. In the next message, we can see Thakur is saying, honest words and deeds are the emblem of honesty. So if somebody has to practice honesty, that person has to demonstrate honest words and deeds. Words and deeds need to be in absolute harmony. Now the question is, how do we overcome go-between? So the Thakur says the only solution is, the moment you realize that you have go-between, the only solution is stop indulging in go-between from that moment. From that very moment, you won't have good time. If you allow you to continue indulging in go-between, then you will never be able to come out of it. It'll become extremely difficult. Stop indulging in go-between from that very moment. That is the prayaschit. That is the penance for indulging in go-between. Towards the end, I would like to very quickly share with you, I know I'm running out of time, an incident from the life of Sri Bodha, who was the eldest son of Sri Sri Thakur and the first Pradhanacharya of Satsang. In his childhood, when he was an adolescent, he was a teenager, one day Sri Bodha had to go to a place, and he had to go there very urgently. And then he knew that a person in the neighborhood has a new bicycle. And he said, if I go and approach and request him for his bicycle, and if he gives me his bicycle, I can reach that place quickly. That person generally was known not to be giving his bicycle to anyone on loan. He was very, very possessive about his bicycle. But when Bodha went to him and asked him for his bicycle, he could not say no, because Sri Sri Thakur's son himself has come and asked him for the bicycle. Sri Bodha promised him that, he said, before a certain time, I will return the bicycle. Sri Bodha had calculated, if he needs about 4 hours, he had told him, I will return to you in about 6 hours. He had factored that extra time. Sri Bodha came back and returned the cycle to him 1 hour prior to the committed time. And before he returned that, Sri Bodha cleaned it properly and oiled the cycle beautifully. The cycle was shining, looking better than when he had taken it from him. Sri Bodha had taken the cycle from this person. This man was extremely excited, delighted to see the cycle which came back to him 1 hour before the committed time, which was shining, dazzling, looking beautiful. Sri Bodha says, every time after that, he comes to me whenever I don't even ask for his cycle. He says, Bodha, why don't you take my cycle if you need it? This is the power of promising and fulfilling your commitments. So I would end here with my prayers at the lotus feet, that all of us be blessed